place in the Open come this evening. Stuart Pollitt, BBC North West Tonight, Lytham St Annes.
Looks so dry there, doesn't it?
It does. Won't get much backspin on the ball. No. Not that I ever can. It's the ultimate train spotters, Des Res, the building behind us, a house with its own railway platform and a daily train service along one of the most scenic routes in England.
Yeah, it is the 140-year-old Dent railway station in Cumbria. It is the highest railway station in the country. Now it has been converted into a family home and it's now up for sale. So if you're a train spotter, this could be the place for you. Juliet Phillips reports.
Beautiful and tranquil, the countryside here has a peacefulness that's pretty undisturbed, until this happens. Dent Station in Cumbria is now up for sale, but the future owner won't have to worry too much about crowds of passengers.
Only around 10 passenger trains like this one stop at Dent Station every day. At 1,150 feet above sea level, it's the highest mainland station in England.
The station was built in 1877. In its heyday, there would be 60 trains stopping here every day. Nowadays, mainly on weekends, you can still see the odd heritage train steaming through. At the moment, the station building is used as a holiday home after it was converted into a house by the current owner, Robin Hughes.
This would have been the main waiting room, so people would have come through the main door there into this area here, nice roaring fire, and they'd have bought a ticket from there.
This, then, is where the ladies would come to wait for their trains.
Absolutely. This is the ladies' waiting room. They'd have bought their tickets through here. They'd sit in here in comfort. The gentlemen would be next door in there, exclusively for ladies. And I've tried to replicate the authentic colours with the maroon aga and the maroon and cream tiles, which are all part of the LMS sort of livery, really.
Transforming the station while keeping many of its historic features took a year of careful renovation work.
I will be emotional because I've had a fantastic time and many good experiences here. We've had many lovely guests. But in 11 years of ownership, it's time for someone else to be the station master, I guess.
So who'd like the chance to live in a station? Or is the idea a bit off the rails?
Buying the station, with it being the house in the middle of nowhere, I feel like that way it would be the best way for me to be like by myself alone, no one bothering me.
I'm not sure I'd be too keen living here. There's not a lot going on around here.
Fantastic. I just wish we could afford it.
Yeah. It's fairly remote out here, but for someone, this place will be just the ticket. Juliet Phillips, BBC North West Tonight, Dent in Cumbria.
Well, it's handy if you just wanted to get on a train. You just walk out your front door.
It's one way of looking at it. Good thinking.
Now, well, thank you very much for everybody watching us because it is a big night, isn't it? In just a few minutes'
not
time.
Not remotely interested in the football.
Well, no, that is
we'll
true.
Make this very short.
No, because they can turn over in a few minutes if they want to. In just a few minutes' time, England take on Colombia in their World Cup knockout match, if you didn't know. Plenty of support here in the Northwest, of course. Have a look at this. This was the scene in Blackpool earlier where football fever reached new heights. The St George's flag is now flying proudly at the top of the tower in support of the team.
Yes, and England's footballers will look to prove that they're a cut above Colombia. And for one Burnley Barber, that would mean a second World Cup call-up because Simon Townley flew to Russia following England's opening match to trim some of the squad's hair. And if they win tonight, he's got to go back and do it all over again. Ian Haslam has been for a trim.
The ball across, Maguire went for it!
If a world... Ian Haslam, BBC Northwest Tonight, Burnley.
Lots of short backs and sides, weren't they?
I can't believe Ian let someone touch his hair. It's precious, that hair.
I was a teenager, my great aunt used to cut my hair.
Put a bowl on it.
Honestly,
go round it.
Like basing it, really was.
She's not still doing it then.
Bless her, no, she's long gone.
Oh, sorry.
No, don't worry. She was an old lady. Diane, dig her out of a hole. How's the weather going?
I've got more chance of understanding the offside rule than what's a line and a fade.
A line and a fade.
And a haircut.
No.
Men's stuff.
Don't
it's
ask
a whole
for
other
it.
World,
men's
isn't it, Annabelle?
Stuff,
we've got no idea. Good evening to you. We've had another glorious day today. Temperatures up at 27 degrees. Everyone is still asking, how long is this weather going to last? Well, just a very lonely cloud in our weather picture today. It's going to pick up some friends as we head through the next couple of days. But, you know, there will just be a few bits of cloud floating around. It doesn't change anything too much. But over the last couple of weeks, we've had you know, the huge sun symbols, we're just seeing a little bit more cloud. We're still going to see some really good temperatures. If you look toward the weekend, we're back up at 28 as we head through the weekend. So we're heading toward another very, very hot one. But most days this week, the mid-20s feeling and looking very nice. Now, the significant change as we progress through this week, and this should start to come in as we head through Thursday, will be a change in the wind direction, although everything seems to have disappeared. It's obviously just having a bit of a moment, our weather graphics. But we will pick up a northwesterly airflow, and now it's ground to a halt completely. But the northwesterly will do us a huge favour because it will make the coastal areas just a little bit cooler than they have been. Now, the coastal strip has been picking up temperatures of 29 and 30, so a few degrees cooler than the places inland. So I think by the end of the week, it'll be around 22 and 23, and I think that will be very, very bearable. But remember, inland temperatures will still be in the mid to high 20s. Now, through this evening and overnight, it's the same story as the last couple of nights. What we'll see as we head toward the very early hours of the morning is a little bit of cloud floating around now around Pennine District that will start to work its way toward us, but it doesn't do anything. Temperatures between 7 and 11 degrees. And into tomorrow, a little bit of cloud will start the day for some places. It'll burn off relatively quickly by late morning. And after that, well, it's another very, very nice day. Temperatures up to 25, 26, and the UV index continues to be high.
It's the heat's got to your computer, obviously.
We all know what the sun looks like, though, don't we?
Yeah.
We've become very accustomed
to
it.
Normally, you don't have a script. Normally, at least you have a few pictures to help you, give you a few clues.
Anyone can do my job at the minute.
No, they can.
It's hot.
No, it is hot.
Lovely. Yes.
Lovely.
Thank you for watching. You have permission to switch over now, but don't, obviously. It's the BBC. Thank you.
Bye-bye.